And I'm standing under the beautiful plane trees in the centre of the exhibition gardens at Carlton, and I am talking with Peter Donegan. And Peter Donegan has had a wonderful garden, and I think he's won a medal.
Yeah, won a nice gold shiny medal. Yeah.
Is it chocolate?
No, it's not. No, it's a, there's a trophy, I think, that you get on a little placard put next to the name of the garden that just sits outside.
So, Peter, tell me a little bit about the inspiration for your garden.
That's a tricky one to explain, but it's ultimately a love story of a fabled, in this case, Irish man who falls in love with a woman that he can never say how he feels, and so separated by a maritime landscape, as you would see the garden. There's a meander then through a eloquent, beautiful, if I might describe it, as just like a cloudy haze of planting, and then you come to what is a platform of Mollianas to go back into the daydream from construction. What you have is a view from a mainland to an island, and he's hoping that one day she will arrive, but because of the inability to be able to say the magic words, she never turns up. And so the place settings are set as one where his drink is poured, his napkin is used, and hers remains silent, and a locket awaits. But the poem that sits by the edge of the garden, which most people wouldn't see, is a poem by a guy called Sean Hughes called How I Feel, which is a paradox in itself, because the opening line is you are an evergreen and I am a leafless tree, and the closing line is the most romantic thing I can say to you is you're the one I want to have problems with. So he never gets there, but it's the bit behind, I guess in this case, this Irish man. And and if you go through the Irish tenses, where normally you would have past, present, future, there's what's known as the Amshramoch an Ealach. And the Amshramoch an Ealach in Ireland's history, or the history of the language, is probably better known as the daydreamer's tense. It's sort of like if I won the lottery, I would do X, but that's a 1 in 160 billion chance. So now you're back to the case of, will she arrive? Well, there's still a chance, but you're trapped within this sort of a metaphorical island in your head, which is translated into this daydream presented as a garden that's won a medal. And yeah.
And I've noticed you've got some really big rocks. Now, did you bring them from Dublin?
Yeah, the joke I had with the organisers was that I put them into the overhead luggage compartment and it took a little bit to get them in. But the largest of the five rocks weighs 3.748 ton, and the lowest is 3.124 ton. You have 45,000 litres of water, and you have an overall weight of about 65 ton. So for those who are into construction listening to this, if you're not, I apologise sincerely, but you've got to fall over the 20 metre distance of about 400 millimetres, which is about zero to ground level to knee height. And so you have to make a balance in the garden, elevate the whole thing up, and then make it, again, I'll say it, only appear as a daydream. And it's the beauty, I guess, about show gardening, where some accentuate that and allow the elevations to be seen. But in this case, we had to make it appear from the outset that it was so easy to stroll across the water, that it was so easy to stroll through that daydreamed haze of planting to get to the island, where it's, in this case, it's Mollianas limestone instead of what we would have known as black limestone. And I think in that context, we substituted a lot of the garden to bluestone, and then we substituted, for the plant lovers out there, long name alert if you're not, what should have been a Gleditsia triacanthus sunburst, we changed it to a Liriodendron tulipifera. Apologies on the long names, I sound very intelligent when I say them aloud. But the idea was that the tree would, this 8 metre tall tree, I should add, cast that reflection across what is a 13.5 metre distance of water. And it's unusual, when we were building the garden on day three, everybody was saying, my God, this is a massive water feature. And by the time we put the rocks in and put the steppings in, everybody was saying, my God, it's a beautiful garden. So it sort of changes from a house to a home, if that makes any sense. And then I think at this moment in time. Yesterday, where it was raining, everybody was saying, oh my God, based on the love story, it's very dramatic with the rain falling down. And then today the sun comes out and everybody's saying, oh my God, it's so emotive because the sun is bouncing off one rock and reflecting off the black water. So it's quite an unusual landscape considering it's only temporary at a show. But I think the people like it, and I hope your listeners will maybe Google it or see it and fall in love with it as well.
Well, Peter, it's a piece of work. It's really magical and beautiful. Now, how does somebody get invited to the Melbourne International Flower and Garden Show when they live in Ireland?
There's a PA going off in the background. Don't mind them. But there's the joke was that I'm a 21-year overnight success, and that's how long I've been designing under my own name. So I think because about 80% of my work is outside of Ireland, and because we had done stuff in France and we'd done television back home, and I think because we've done maybe other shows abroad, it was a really unusual one. But ultimately, IMG sent me a note saying we'd like to bring you over. I had a conversation then with Martin Semkin, who is the most metal contractor in the history of the show. Martin fell in love with this story, which is, again, I'll double underline this, it really is a fall flat in your face, sink or swim sort of a thing. It was a dangerous show garden game to be playing. We could have done something, and I'll divert slightly. For your listeners at home, when judging show gardens, if we, and it's accepted in brackets, if we had designed a piece of grass and said to the judges we were inspired by Wimbledon Lawns Tennis Club, they see a patch of grass, it looks like it, smells like it, must be it, therefore we get gold. But we chose to do this daydream, and to go back into that again, if we had taken out the hedge 20 metres long and along the left-hand side and made that into a blue stone wall, we would have got another 2 points extra as from the judges, but it would have killed the daydream. And so you're playing with this thing where we know we ultimately couldn't have taken it any further than the goal that we got. I know that sounds a little bit maybe hard to appreciate, that we wanted more from the garden, but at the same token, you don't want to ruin this daydream. And it is the ultimate in, you sit down and say, well, you're the man I want to spend the rest of my life with. And he says, well, let's do the accounting numbers and, you know, see how this is going to work out financially for us. Said no woman ever. That is music to my ears, and if I don't spend the rest of my life with you, I'll have itchy trousers. Life isn't worth living. You can't work it that way. And again, I'll say it, the objective was daydream. The behind the scenes is something that came from my head, turns into a series of equations or 48 pages of drawings. And then you go to a company like Semkin, who are entrusted with working alongside me, and we did that, I think, very eloquently together, and it becomes what the visitors see. And there's a lovely drone shot somebody took, or drone photograph, where it looks almost identical to the illustration that we drew way back in August, and now we're March heading, well, we're April tomorrow, I think, or day after as you listen to this. And it's really baffling that you see this thing made real. We'd one lady come up today and said, hey, can I paint your garden? And I'm going, oh my God, it's now taken another life form. And that sounds really silly, but when you consider in 5 days, 3 days' time, that entire garden is going to be taken apart and dismantled. And now my head is saying, it gets to live forever. It's like a love song. It's like a poem. You're back to it again. So for somebody to say that to me, my head is kind of going, well, you know, we've sort of aced it, if you will.
Well, Peter, it's been a pleasure talking to you. I should let you get back. You've got a queue of people asking you about your design. So thank you very much for joining me, Peter Donegan.
Thanks, Molly. And to the listeners of 88.3 Southern FM, thank you so much. Absolute pleasure, Molly.